Time to unwrap the Lightning and Islanders series with the help from our friends over at Upper Deck. Got a couple of cards here in this pack, specifically to the Eastern Conference Final. And okay. How about Brock Nelson? Right. Took a beating there physically in game number two. Sounds like he's okay, good to go moving forward. Yeah. How important is that for the Islanders if they want to have success in this series?
Oh, I think it's essential, JMO, without question, especially where this series has gone so far. But, you know, it's interesting in our business. We spend a lot of time talking about the players that are streaky, that are putting up big numbers. We talk a lot about the players that are struggling, that are off pace. We don't spend near enough time talking about the guys that are just regular, great, consistent at what they do, and that's number 29 for the Isles. Nelson, since his sophomore year, is plus 20 goals every year, an integral part of that second string through the Islanders lineup. The B line.
The Killer Bees.
Brock Bailey.
Beauvillier.
Beauvillier. Right. Fun to say.
Exactly. This one, fun to say, fun card to look at, fun guy to have on your team. Victor Hedman. He can do a little bit of everything right now. He's proving that.
Never get tired of talking about the big Swede. I mean, so effective on both sides of the puck. Victor has shown to me, he really has risen to the occasion this postseason. Has a great sense of these moments when the opposition is laying off. Look at how he eats up the open ice, gets closer to the net before he unleashes a shot like that. But a fabulous defender on the other side of the puck as well. You mentioned a great moment just a couple of nights ago. That big read, that turnover on the 5-on-4, steps into the gap and sends it the distance. Critical moment in a big win for the Bolts.
All right, we've got a couple of goaltenders coming out right now. Okay. How about Varlamov here for the Islanders? Barry Trotz has kind of alternated between the two netminders. Mm-hmm. How about this guy? He seems to be the guy if the Islanders are going to go deep.
Yeah, and I think the encouraging thing for the Isles in game two of this series, you know, there was a bit of a question. Is it Varlamov? Is it Greiss? Who's going to give us that number one type goaltending to make this a competitive series for us or ultimately come out on top in this series? But Varlamov in game two, I thought really dialed it up well, made some critical saves for the Isles versus the Bolts. Perhaps a turning point at the goaltending position for the Isles.
All right, you see this one? It says MVP, Andre Vasilevskiy.
Say
might,
no more.
Might
Say
be
no
the
more.
MVP when all said and done, the way he's playing. Maybe the front runner for the Conn Smythe right now? What do you think?
I think that's probably a fair assessment. I mean, he really has shown no chinks in the armor. This is a guy, you know, probably at this position, the best athlete across the number one netminders league-wide. Great big guy, 6'3", tips him in at around 220 pounds, but it's all twisted steel. Fabulous athlete, incredibly flexible, great reads, and I tell you what, the Isles are finding this out in a very, very blunt way. He's really hard to solve. Does not give you a lot and does not create a lot of extra work for himself.
Well, the cool thing about Upper Deck, they give us a ton. And this is the coolest part about this segment. You get to open some packs.
Okay,
you were just
that.
Telling me off camera that as a kid you used to open them and chuck them against the wall?
Chuck them against the wall. Closest to the wall,
is that a Western
you get
Canada
both
kind
cards.
Of thing? What?
I think so.
Okay.
I think so.
Was there a name for it?
I had a pretty good stack.
I bet. You probably just beat kids up if they didn't give you the cards.
I will say, my first ever professional hockey card came out on Upper Deck. That was my rookie card. It was a big moment.
All right.
It was a big moment. They do cards extremely well.
Really well. Who do you got over there? Anything
Here's
good?
One of my favorites, Dustin Brown.
Okay,
Dustin
I like
Brown.
It.
Heart and soul of the
Absolutely.
LA Kings lineup, my friend.
Going through it. I got TJ Oshie, so you know if we go to a shootout, I'm just going to throw that card out there.
Okay.
That'll get it done.
I got another third on the B line. There's Josh Bailey.
Yeah, Bailey, Killer Bees.
Bailey.
I got a B, a Boston Bruin, Patrice Bergeron,
okay.
Potential fifth Selke. That would set an all-time mark. You're not into that? Okay, cool. Let's move on. What do you got, JT
I'm
Miller?
I'm too focused on my cards.
Guess,
These shots
my
are
goodness.
So great.
This is supposed to be a dialogue, What do you got? What do you have
I got
over
an
there?
Alec Martinez, and I got to believe that's an early jersey or an early card. Martinez in a Vegas jersey.
Yeah.
Looks really sharp.
JT Miller, how big of a piece was he?
Oh,
coming
yeah.
from Tampa to Vancouver, a big reason why this team is probably poised to make a couple of deep runs.
And I think brings a little experience along
yes.
with them to bring
yeah.
some of these young guys along. I
yeah.
like that acquisition. And I tell you what, a great playoff run for he and his Canucks.
What do you got? Anything else? You
what
showed
else
me like one of them.
Mika Zibanejad.
That's a good one.
What do you say about
one.
That?
The stick probably goes off the page.
It does indeed.
Yeah.
It does indeed.
Incredible. That guy gets it done. All right, we're done right here. More NHL tonight coming
good
up
stuff.
Next. So you just chuck them against the wall? Is that you
just flip them like that. Closest to. There's a whole technique.
Unwrap is presented by Upper Deck. UpperDeckEPAC.com lets you buy, open, and collect your favorite hockey cards from anywhere at any time. Get a free pack every day just for logging on. Visit UpperDeckEPAC.com today.